morning children. I am your English teacher. I hope you are all safe and fine. Today we are going to see Unit 2 English Lesson 1 Trip to Ooty. So Unit 1 already we have completed. Now we are going to see Unit 2 Lesson 1. Lesson name is Trip to Ooty. So in this lesson we have 3 sections, but we are going to see today section 1. Okay children? Yes. Look at the picture. They are enjoying the picnic. I am going to ask questions. Where would you like to go for a picnic? Yes. Beach, waterfall, garden, so etc. Would you like to go
along with your
parents or parents? Sometimes with our parents, sometimes with our friends. How do you prepare yourself for a picnic? Yes. We have to take what are the things we need for a picnic. Why do we arrange educational trips in our schools? In our schools, they arrange educational trip to learn something about the climate, places, history, nature, so etc. Before getting to the lesson, let us learn some words and their meanings. Yes, glossary, mesh, material made of a network or wire or thread. Swaying, moving slowly or rhythmically. Snaking, moving like a snake. Snigger, laughed in a half-suppressed way. Again, I repeat these words. Mesh, material made of a network of wire or thread. Swaying, moving slowly or rhythmically. Snaking, moving like a snake. Snigger, laughed in a half-suppressed way. Yes, children, let us get into the lesson now. Trip to Ooty in section 1. Have you gone to Ooty? Yes. Few of us living in Ooty and few of us gone to Ooty. Ooty is a very good place for summer vacation. It is known as Queen of Hills. Do you know that? Yes. Here, there is a girl. She writes a letter to her friend about her trip to Ooty. Yes. If we go for some other places, we usually share with our friends and family members, isn't it? Yes. Come, let us see what she showed with her friends. So this lesson is in the letter format. Okay, this lesson will be in the letter format. If we want to write a letter, first what we have to mention? Place, date. She also mentioned the same. Okay. I'm going to tell what she is going to write. She lives in Coimbatore. So, she mentioned Coimbatore and date on 20th 11 2017. Whenever we write a letter to our friends, we have used an informal letter. What we have to use? Dear friend or dear friend name, isn't it? Yes. So she also used dear Malli. Malli is her friend name. Okay, let us see the lesson. So in letter format is there, Coimbatore, 20th 11 2017. Dear Malli, thanks for your letter and it was great to hear from you. You asked me to tell you about my trip to Ooty with my friends. I had the most wonderful time. 20 girls and boys from class 6 went on trip. Our class teacher Geeta Madam and 2 others took us. So in this first paragraph, I will explain to you. The girl who writes a letter, her name is Merlin. Her friend name is Mally. So in the beginning of the letter, Merlin thanked her friend for her letter, and her friend asked about her trip to Ooty with her friends. Merlin told that was the most wonderful time. 20 girls and boys from class 6 went on the trip. Her class teacher, Geeta Madam, and others, for other teachers, took them. And then second paragraph, my grandmother has told me about a beautiful journey to Ooty by the toy train many times. She said that it was a spectacular trip up and down the slopes with birds and trees dancing along. Ooty is so close to Coimbatore, but I have never been there nor seen that train. So I was really thrilled when the school arranged this trip. You can imagine how excited I was when I stepped into a toy train with my friends. So already grandmother told her about a beautiful journey to Ooty by the toy train many times. Her grandmother said that was a spectacular trip. Spectacular means eye-catching. And it was up and down that slopes with birds and trees dancing along. Ooty is very close to Coimbatore, but Merlin have been there. No, nor seen that train. So she was thrilled when her school arranged this trip. Just imagine to you that our school arranged means, how do you feel? Yes, we are very excited, isn't it? Yes. She also excited when she stepped into the toy train with her friends. Then, I looked around at the wooden chairs with cushioned seat and oil-painted walls as I put my bag on the mesh of the luggage rack. I was bubbling over with excitement. So after getting to the train, she looked around the wooden chairs and cushioned seats and walls were painted with oil paint. She put her bag on the mesh of a luggage rack. Mesh means material made of a network of wire or thread. And she was bubbling over with excitement. Bubbling means with her happiness, and we make sound. And next page. Hi Fatima, isn't it this one? I called out as my friend came into the compartment. Come sit here. I have kept a seat for you. You can keep your bag next to mine. What do you have to brought to eat? She said, parotta and delicious chutney. Did you see the train? It's so beautiful, Fatima replied. So Merlin called her Fatima and her friend Fatima, and she asked her to come and sit near her. And she kept a seat for her. And she told her to keep her bag next to her bag. And she asked, what have you brought to eat? She replied, parotta and delicious chutney. And Merlin asked her, did you see the train? She told that, so beautiful, Merlin. So when are you going to picnic with your friends? Always used to sit with your best friend, isn't it? Yes. So and we used to keep her place also. So she also did the same. And next paragraph, our teacher Geeta Madam came around to see if everyone was seated properly. The train is about to leave, so take your seats, everyone, she said. Just then the train started with a jerk. It moved very slowly, leaving the station with a long hoot. Everyone clapped. The train went snaking up the steep hillside, weaving its way through forest of tall trees swaying in the breeze. So Merlin class teacher came to her see around everyone was seated properly or not. Then she told them, the train is about to leave, so take your seats, everyone. Then the train started with a jerk. The train was moving slowly, leaving the station with a long hoot. Long hoot means loud sound. Everyone clapped. The train went snaking the steep hills, went through the forest, then the trees swaying in the breeze. Snaking means the train was moving like a snake. Swaying means moving slowly like in the breeze. Then one of the boys, Muthu, said, "It is going so slowly, I can walk along its side." And he got up to go to the door. From the other end, the teacher saw him and said in a firm voice, "Muthu, go back to your seat at once." The girl sniggered and Muthu sat down with a long face. So one of the boys from Merlin class, he said that the train is moving very slowly, I can walk along its side, and he started going near to the door. At the time, Merlin class teacher saw him and said that in a firm voice, "Muthu, go back to your seat." The girl sniggered. Sniggered means laugh in a half suppressed way. And Muthu sat down with a long face. Do you know why the teacher shouted at him? Yes, because he was standing near to the door by the train. It's very dangerous. So whenever we travel in the train, we should not leave the head out of the window. And we should not stand near the door while in the traveling. While in the education tour, we have to obey our teacher and be careful in traveling in the train. I hope you are all understood in this section 1 in this lesson. Next session we will see in the next class. Thank you, children.